Hello, I'm Bruce Rose. I provide technical support for CUI, a Bel Group. CUI offers power supplies, including USB. A recent addition to USB is USB-C, which is the connector, and then USB-PD, which is a power delivery protocol. USB-C is the physical connector. All it defines is the dimensions and the construction of the connector. One of the most profound differences of a USB-C connector versus previous connectors is it can plug in either direction. There is no right and wrong that we had on USB-A and the previous connectors that you would try and plug it in and it wouldn't work. You'd try it again and it would finally work because there was a right and a wrong. USB-C, there is no right and wrong. It goes in either direction. Associated with the USB-C connector, there's also many more signal lines internal and connections internal to the connector than were in the previous generation. And so having these more signal lines allows more advanced protocols for information and power transfer through the connector. PD is a power delivery protocol, and that defines the signals that flow through this connector in USB. In previous power delivery schemes, only 5 volts was to be delivered through USB. With USB PD, we can deliver 5 volts, we can deliver 9 volts, 12 volts, 15 volts, or 20 volts, and at different current levels, up to 20 amps, which exceeds what previous connectors were able to handle and previous protocols. Again, to reiterate, the USB-C describes just the connector. The PD describes the signals that pass through the connector. But the truth be known, what the public is going to end up calling it really isn't material. They're all going to recognize it's the same connector and the same signals, whether it's C or PD. And so we'll just have to see as time passes whether we end up calling it a USB connector, a USB-C connector, or perhaps a USB PD. CUI recognizes that this concept of USB-C and USB-PD is new and will be confusing to a lot of people, both to developers and to customers. And so in order to help people to understand and learn more quickly, CUI has programs in place in terms of blogs, videos, white papers that are helping to explain what is happening with USB-C and USB-PD. CUI also recognizes that the USB-C and PD protocol are what's going to be very popular in the future, and thus we have a line of products that provide both USB-C connectors and support the PD protocol. When transitioning to the USB-C from what we had been doing with the previous USB-A and mini and micro, there are some challenges that come to pass, and that is USB-C is a higher performance and protocol, and so there's a need for cables that can support the power levels and the data interfaces. While the USB consortium has defined a method to identify cables that are appropriate for USB-C and USB-PD, not everybody uses those identifying marks, and so it's up to the consumer, the user, to be able to look at their cables and understand what it is they need and what it will achieve. USB-A has served us well in many applications. They tend to be lower power and lower data rates. Some examples are flash drives, mice, keyboards, headphones, things like that work really well with the USB-A. However, as we move into more advanced technology, monitors, telecommuting, telehealth, things like that, where we want much more power and data transfer, then USB-A is lacking. And this is where USB starts to shine. As the world and the users are transitioning from USB-A to USB-C, there will still be the need for support of USB-A chargers and products, and CUI will support that need. We will be providing USB-C based power supplies and USB-A based power supplies, depending upon the need of the customer. Another application for the USB-C connector and protocol that will become very popular is when charging devices such as cell phones, tablets, computers, laptops, that they all need different voltage levels and different power levels. Previously, we had an array of connectors and chargers to be able to handle all of our different products. The advantage of USB-C is it will have the same connector and protocol that will enable the different voltages levels and the different power levels to be able to charge this array of devices. We're going to show the capability of USB-C to negotiate different voltages and power levels. I have my laptop computer here that's partially charged, and I have some different USB-C power supplies that we'll use to charge laptop. And then what I have is an inline DMM, digital multimeter, to monitor the voltage and current, make it so I can read it. I'm seeing 20.0 volts. Pretty wonderful. It's charging the laptop. And if we look at our screen over here, the laptop is saying life is good. I'm getting a full charge. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to unplug the 100 watt adapter and I'm going to replace it with a 45 watt adapter. And so I plug that in and I give it a moment for the DMM to settle and the negotiations to complete. And I still see 20 volts, but when I look over at my screen over here, I have a message saying I can't charge at the full rate. And this is what USB-C is doing. On the first one, it negotiated not only a voltage level, but a maximum current level. On the second one, it was not able to achieve the desired maximum current level, but it said it's good enough. And so it's charging slowly with a smaller adapter, whereas it was able to charge fully fast with a big adapter. CUI USB products that employ the C connector and the PD protocol follow the compliance standards as defined by the USB consortium. In following these standards, it ensures that the user, when they take a CUI power supply and plug it in, knows that the CUI power supply will behave in a certain manner as defined by the standards, and therefore everything will be working properly. The applications for USB-C and PD are growing daily. And right now we're seeing a lot of applications that are maybe at about 100 watts at most, but we're soon going to be seeing applications taking advantage of the 240 watt level. Some examples of comparing and contrasting in the medical field, the blood pressure monitor, a portable blood pressure monitor, only needs a few watts to charge it. However, a CPAP machine that's also a portable machine may use the full 240 watts. Again, we've already talked about cell phones use fairly low power to charge, laptops use higher power to charge. We've got electric bicycles, we've got electric carts, industrial robots, all these things could use battery packs to untether them from the wall, but still need to be charged, and a USB PD protocol works well for those applications. The USB-C and PD standards have defined protocols for delivering up to 48 volts at 5 amps or 240 watts. Today, CUI is offering power levels up to 100 watts. That's a very common level that is available in the industry. As more demand exists up at the higher power levels, CUI will be producing products that support those power levels. At the same time, we understand that the USB-A market still exists. We will have products still to support that market, and the legacy market that needed the specific connectors, specific power levels, voltages, and currents still exist, and CUI will continue to offer products for that market. At CUI, we receive many questions regarding the USB and its technologies and protocols. We understand there's a lot of new information. Our recommendation is to think of three takeaways from this. The USB-A protocol is a legacy protocol that has served the market very well, but its limitations are 5 volts only, moderately low power, and reasonable data rates. USB-C has been introduced, and the USB-C itself is just the physical connector. Associated with the USB-C connector is USB PD protocol. This protocol enables high power levels to be delivered through the USB-C connector to support the new and advanced technologies our customers are demanding. For more information, please visit our website or contact us directly. Thank you.